It was supposed to be high-quality Australian beef produced on idyllic green pastures on the outskirts of Sydney. But a Nine News investigation has uncovered a dirty secret that both the farmers and their cattle have been contaminated by chemicals from the nearby RAAF base at Richmond.
Morning.
Hi, Alistair. How are you going today?
All right.
It's a simple enough thing getting a blood test. For the McLaren family, this isn't a simple test, and the implications could be life-changing. Father Alistair, Mother Kelly, and their four children, the youngest just 10.
Walk up.
The McLarens have been on their Richmond farm for 4 years, running a grass-fed beef business, selling their meat directly to loyal customers.
We were immensely proud of the product we were producing, and people would come back and say, wow, this is the best beef we've ever eaten.
But that is now over. The McLarens' property is just 100 metres from the Richmond RAAF base, where firefighting foam containing per- and polyfluoroalkyl substances, known as PFAS, was used and dumped for decades, ending up in the water table. That same water flows through both the base and this farm, the same water these prized cattle drank, the same water nurturing the grass these animals still eat.
Our biggest concerns are that we don't know the concentration levels that we have in our animals, if any at all.
Nor do they know what's in their systems. The McLarens believe the Defence Department knew about the dangers of PFAS for a decade and a half, but only notified them late last year that there was a problem.
We have known for decades that these compounds are actually toxic.
Environmental scientist Professor Mark Taylor says PFAS chemicals accumulate, take a long time to dissipate, and could be linked to a range of risks, including birth defects, developmental issues, and immune problems. US studies suggest links to cancers.
The evidence is still emerging with respect to the effects. So if you were to apply a precautionary approach, you would say, I don't really want these chemicals in my body or in my food or in my water.
The family was told by the health department not to eat more than 200 grams of their own meat each month. Defence said they could have 50 serves. But selling it, they were told, was not a problem. They didn't see it that way, halting sales in the middle of last year.
We don't know exactly how we're directly affected and how our customers are affected by eating this product.
Testing for the presence of PFAS is expensive, thousands of dollars this family couldn't afford. Neither Defence nor the Health Department would help, so Nine News did the testing for them of the family and their cattle using a lab accredited at the highest standard. The results are damning. A typical 31 to 45-year-old adult would have a reading of 3.9 nanograms per millilitre of blood, 2.9 for children. For the key chemical, Alistair had a reading of 66 nanograms per millilitre of his blood. His son Michael, 44, Hamish, 39, daughter Eliza, 23, wife Kelly, 21. As for his cattle, as high as 390. Alarmingly, even a day-old calf had a reading of 72.
We're devastated. We thought that there may have been some hope that there wasn't any contamination, but it's pretty bad.
Even though Alistair's levels were highest, he worries about his family and his customers because they trusted his meat.
And sort of letting everybody down, I suppose. It's been tough.
He believes Defence should have warned him the land was unsuitable before he set up his farm.
It's just like a slow-moving avalanche that they know it's coming, but they're just letting everybody stand in the way.
Unlike Richmond, contamination around other bases such as Williamtown in the Hunter Valley is being confronted in some cases through the courts. Now, the Australian government's expert health panel report recognises that low-level exposure to PFAS may be damaging. As for what's safe, well, that's still being debated, but not in the US, where levels considered safe are 10 times lower than they are here.
Not surprisingly, Alistair McLaren has lost faith in those he trusted to help him.
We've got Defence investigating Defence, government agencies investigating government agencies. The EPA need to grow a set. They have been next to useless.
The McLarens want Defence to admit the problem and use them as a test case.
There's a lot of people who won't stand up for fear of whatever it is, but we've got nothing left to lose. We've lost everything.
Eddie Meyer, Nine News.